Favorite Sesame Street episode is the one where Hooper's store catches fire, because we watched that with my daughter at 3 and a half right after September 11th. And the next day she had a fire in her nursery school. And while she was very frightened by all the noise and the sirens, when the firemen came in, she said to her dad, "Look, those are just like the firemen that Elmo saw on Sesame Street." And she waved to the firemen and they waved back. And I was so grateful she had that information to get her through that scary time.
Playing chess. I love chess. May I play chess?
Yeah, sure. You can play the winner.
Oh, good.
And that would be me.
What?
Ooh.
Checkmate.
Oh, boy, that was nice.
I didn't even see that coming. Wow, you win. Good game, Alan.
Ah, thanks, Gordon.
All right, see you guys later. I promised the kids I'd go play ball with them.
All right. Have fun, Gordon.
Okay, everybody, let's play ball.
Get ready, Alan. I am a big bad chess player.
I'm ready, big bad.
Okay,
whoa, you go first.
Oh, thank you.
And checkmate.
Checkmate? What do you mean, checkmate?
That means I won.
You won? Then I lost?
Yes, but hey, that's okay.
I lost! I can't believe I lost!
It's okay, Big Bad. Hey, it's only a game.
Only a game? Only a game? Well, I'm gonna huff and puff and blow this game away! Sorry, Alan. I just don't like to lose at chess. I feel so disappointed that I have to huff and puff.
Well, maybe you should find another game to play. One that doesn't make you want to huff and puff.
Yeah. Hey, I know. I can play baseball. I love baseball.
Great.
See you later, Alan.
Yeah.
Thanks for the game.
Bye.
But not till you hit it.
Foul ball, man. Here comes the pitch.
Okay. You do it this time, Bobby.
And here he comes, and...
Oh, feels good. Yay!
Oh,
everybody! Hey, everybody! May I play baseball? I am quite a good baseball player.
Oh, sure, Big Bad.
Okay, wait till you see how I hit the ball. I am a big, bad ball player. Better stand back.
Oh, okay.
Okay, you ready, Big Bad?
Oh, I'm ready, Gordon.
Here comes the pitch.
Okay. What do you mean, strike one?
Well, you've missed the ball, Big Bad. That means you have strike one.
Yeah.
But don't worry, you've got a good swing.
Yeah, you can do it.
Here comes
another
pitch.
Here
comes another pitch. And
strike two.
Okay, but this time just keep your eye on the ball, Big Bad. It's okay. Here we go.
Okay.
And
strike three. You're out.
I'm out. What do you mean out.
Well, that's how you play the game, Big Bear. Three strikes and you're out.
Well, I'm not out. I can't be out. I am so disappointed.
But, Big Bear, it's only a game.
Only a game? Only a game?
Yeah, Big Bear. I'm a stressed out all the time.
Yeah, me too.
Well, here's what I think of your game.
Whoa! Oh, boy. Look.
Wow, he huffed and puffed us.
Yeah, Elmo's never been huffed and puffed before.
Yeah, me either. You know, maybe I ought to go have a little talk with Big Bad.
Well, can we finish our game first?
Oh, okay, sure.
Okay. Play ball! Yay!
There. You ready to play, Radar? How about you, Dinger?
Hey, what you playing, Big Bird?
Oh, hi, Big Bad. Radar and I are playing the Guess What's Next game, and the Dinger's gonna help.
Ooh, may I play? I love the Guess What's Next game, and I am a really great guesser.
Well, sure, why not? Okay, see, now what I've done here, I've made a pattern with some of Radar's friends.
Uh-huh.
You see, there's a teddy bear.
Yeah.
And two bunnies.
One, yeah.
Two. Another teddy bear and two more bunnies. One,
uh-huh.
Two. And now you have to see what would come next. Okay?
Uh-huh.
You have to guess what comes next before the dinger rings the bell.
Ooh, ooh, I can do that.
Okay, but first we have to sing the song.
Oh, yeah. I love the song.
Guess what's next? What could it be? There's a pattern that you can see. Guess what's next? Can you tell? Guess by the time you hear the bell.
Okay, Big Bad, guess what's next?
Okay, let's see. There's one teddy bear, then two bunny rabbits, then one teddy bear, then two bunny rabbits.
Did you figure it out?
I'm thinking.
Too bad. There's the bell.
The bell? Well, but yeah, I did not guess yet.
Well, the time is up, though.
You mean I lost?
Yes, well, I'm sorry. But, did you guess? Well, the answer is one bear. Because there's one teddy bear, two bunnies, another teddy bear, two bunnies, and another teddy bear. It's Radar.
But I was gonna say that. You didn't give me a chance to ding or ding it too soon.
Well, just don't get upset. It's okay.
But I lost! I lost! I lost! I am so disappointed!
But it's only a game.
Only a game? Only a game?
Well, yeah, it's the Guess What's Next game. Hey! Hey, stop that! All right, look what you just did. You huffed and puffed Radar and his friends. And the dinger, too.
Yeah, and guess what's next?
Huh? I just got huffed and puffed by the big bad wolf.
Well, so did we.
Wow.
Does Big Bad want to play basketball with us?
Yeah, that would be good.
Yeah,
hey, right. Did somebody say basketball? Oh, how I love basketball. May I play basketball?
No.
Hey, why won't you let the big bad wolf play?
Yeah.
Because he's a sore loser.
Yeah.
Zoe.
Yeah, every time he loses, he always huffs and puffs.
Yeah, and Elmo doesn't like getting huffed and puffed.
No.
Oh, I'm sorry. It's just that I do not like to lose. I get so upset that I have to huff and puff.
But nobody likes to lose, Big Bad.
They don't?
No.
But you can't win all the time.
Nobody can.
You win some, you lose some, that's part of the game.
You win some, you lose some, the fun is the same.
You can't win them all,
but you might win a few.
The fun is in doing the best you can do.
Yeah, you hear
today's not your day.
No. Tomorrow, a grand slam might come your way.
You can't win them all,
but you could win just one.
The fun is the game, and the game is the fun.
Right.
You met some.
Don't get some.
That's part of the game.
Right.
You catch some.
You drop some.
The fun is the same.
Whether you've lost or whether you've won,
the fun's in the game, and the game.
So it's okay to feel disappointed if you lose, Big Bad.
Yeah, but it's not okay to huff and puff. That just ruins everyone's fun.
Yeah.
I understand. Next time I lose, I will try not to huff and puff.
Great.
Right.
So, can I play basketball?
Well, let's see what you're about to play. Okay.
All right.
Oh, really? Thank you.
There
you go. This is good.
Come on.
Oh, here comes Big Bad down the court. He sees an opening. He shoots. I missed. I am so disappointed.
Hold on.
Uh-oh.
Could I try that again, please?
Oh, yes. Sure you can.
Thanks, Gordon. Here comes Big Bad for another shot. He shoots. Back to work.
Oh, no. We want you to play in the basketball game.
Yeah. Elmo loves playing with the Big Bad Wolf now.
Yeah, me too.
Maybe tomorrow. Right now, I've got a job to do. I can't let the fairy tale down. I'm going to get you, little piggies.
You can't catch us.
Oh, yeah? Well, I'm going to huff and puff and blow your houses in. Hey, it's what I do. Come back here, piggies.
Tamara, anything you want to talk about?
Well, how's about winning?
Winning?
Yeah.
Okay, you talked about winning.
Winning is a good thing. Well, how I feel about winning is a good thing. But even if you win or lose, you still need to practice. And you'd be happy for someone who wins, because that's a good thing.
Mm-hmm, that is right. And how about losing?
Losing? Well, you can be good even if you lose. You can just be happy if somebody else has won. You can give them a shake on the hand.
Mm-hmm.
You can give them high five. You can say, nice for you to win.
So you can be happy losing and winning.
Right.
Yeah.
On the island of emotion, surrounded by the ocean, feelings are filling the air. Come on, let me show you what's there. Look at the smiles in Happy Harbor. Pelicans sing a giggly song. Sailboats are skipping on the water. Seagulls are laughing all night long. Let's have a cry at Weeping River. That's where to lose your misery. Cry all your sadness in the river. Wash all your troubles out to sea. On the islands of emotion, come on with me. Down at the Love Lagoon, it's lovely. Everyone's strolling hand in hand. See how the breeze is blowing kisses. See how the waves all hug the sand. Anyone found the big surprises? Visits the famous woods of Yao. Behind every tree are new surprises. Waiting for you, here comes one now. Yao! Sadness and happiness, love and surprise. Now we must finally say our goodbyes to the island of emotion.
Nothing like a brisk morning jog while my porridge cools. Hey, somebody's been eating my porridge. And they ate it all up. Why does this always happen to me?
bowl of porridge up in the air and make an angry mess.
Oh, baby bear, what's going on here?
What's going on?
Yes.
What's going on, Whoopi? I'll tell you what's going on. Somebody keeps eating all my porridge.
They do, huh?
Yeah.
How does that make you feel?
Well, it makes me feel really, really angry.
Really, really angry?
Yeah, it makes me wanna throw this porridge bowl up in the air and make an angry mess.
Well, I can understand that.
Well, I don't expect... You can?
Sure. There have been plenty of times when I've been really, really angry. I wanted to throw my porridge bowl up in the air and make an angry mess, too.
Really?
Yeah.
Well, what did you do? Did you throw your porridge bowl up in the air and make an angry mess?
No.
Well, then what did you do?
Well, sometimes when I get really angry, I do this. I'm really angry.
And does that make you feel better?
Sometimes.
Let me try that.
All right.
Really, really angry.
How do you feel now?
I feel a little better. But I still feel some residual anger.
Okay. Baby bear.
What?
I have another thing I can show you that I do when I'm angry.
Okay, what?
You ready?
Yeah, what?
I'm so angry. Oh!
That looks therapeutic. Let me try that one.
All right.
I'm so angry. Yeah.
So, how do you feel now?
It worked, Whoopi. I feel not a wee bit of anger. Thank you.
Well, you're welcome.
Wow. You know what I feel now?
What?
I feel a big bear hug coming on. Come here, Whoopi.
Those cookies smell so good. Cookie Monster! Oh, Cookie Monster! Come get your cookies!
Cookies! For me!
Yes, Cookie Monster!
But it's not my birthday.
Oh, I know it's not your birthday, but it is time for the letter of the day.
What does that have to do with cookies?
Well, you know how you always eat the letter of the day?
Well, maybe occasional nibble.
Yeah, well, now you can eat all these cookies instead. Yep, there are just enough cookies here for you to eat while I tell everyone about the letter of the day.
Me like how you think, Barry Dawn.
Good. Well, let us begin.
Yeah.
Now, the letter of the day is my very favorite letter. It is the last letter of the alphabet, and it starts with a... What?
You're done.
What? You're done, but I didn't even get to tell everyone that the letter of the day is the letter Z.
So?
Well, I didn't get to say that the letter Z begins words like zipper, and zoo, and zesty.
Well, it's okay, Barry. Just give me more cookies.
But I do not have any more cookies.
No more cookies.
No, that's all I made.
But me so hungry. Me got to eat something. There got to be something.
No, you don't have to eat anything. No, wait, Cookie Monster, we have no cookies.
Oh, yeah. Homemade.
This is the letter Z.
Z, 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 Z,
Z, Z, Z,
My name is Zelda. That's Zelda with a Z. A Z sounds a little like a bee buzzing, like zzzz. I've decided that today is Z Day, but there just seem to be zero words that begin with the letter Z. Zip. Can you think of any words that begin with the letter Z? Me neither. I'm going to look for some.
Hi, Zachary.
Hi, Zelda.
Can you think of any words that start with the letter Z?
Nope. Maybe we can find some together.
Good idea.
We walked all day in a zigzag, but we just couldn't find any words that began with the letter Z. Zilch. So we went home for dinner.
Delicious. What's in this?
Zucchini.
What's for dessert?
Zabaione. We got totally exhausted looking for the letter Z. So we decided to start again the next day with renewed zeal.
Good morning, class.
Good morning, Professor Grover.
Oh, hello there. It is I, your adorable, furry blue Professor Grover here. And today, I am going to teach you the Spanish word zapato. Yes, zapato. Repeat after me, class. Zapato.
Zapato.
Very good. Now, this is what you do with a zapato. You wear it on your hand.
No.
No? Oh, silly me. Ha ha. You wear it on your head.
No.
No? Well, then where do you wear a zapato?
On your feet.
Oh, very good. Very good, class. Yes, I was just testing you. Ha ha. Okay, class dismissed. Mm-hmm. Very good. You all get A's. Mm-hmm. I don't know. I think it's kind of stylish.
Hop, 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 and shake your head. Hop, 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 and shake your head. Hop, hop, shake your head. And wriggle like an octopus. Hop, hop, shake your head. Wriggle like an octopus. Octopus, wriggle with me. I'm dancing with an octopus and I feel free. Hop, hop, shake your head and wriggle like an octopus.
Like that. Oh, look, I'm building a castle. Just one more block.
It's time to play Journey to Ernie, where Ernie hides and Big Bird seeks.
Oh, I love that game.
I know you do.
Oh, I wonder where Ernie's gonna hide today.
Oh! Huh?
You'll see. Come on, Rubber Ducky.
Woohoo!
Oh, quick, count to 10 and no peeking. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. Ready or not, here we come. Whoa. Wow. Ha ha. I have a feeling we're not on Sesame Street anymore. Where are we?
It's a jungle out here.
Oh, we must be in the jungle. Do you see Ernie? Ernie! Ernie, where are you? Not down here. Well, I don't see Ernie anywhere, do you? What's that? Behind me? Oh, look! Stripes! Just like Ernie's shirt. Found you! Ernie, come out! You're not Ernie. You're an elephant. And why are you wearing a shirt on your nose?
It's not a shirt. It's a trunk warmer. You should try it.
Come on. We gotta keep looking. He's got to be here somewhere. Hi, guys.
Ooh, what?
Have you seen Ernie?
Ernie! How'd you pull that striped shirt? Did you buy the rubber ducky? Ernie!
Which way did he go?
That way.
Now, he said this way, and he said that way. This way, 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 that way. Whoa. Oh, where is he? What's that? Rubber ducky? Where? Oh, look, it is Rubber Ducky. And where Rubber Ducky is, Ernie is, which means we found Ernie.
Hey, haven't you ever heard a knocking?
Sorry, but that's Ernie's Rubber Ducky.
No, that's Bernie's Rubber Ducky.
Who's Bernie?
Me. Oh. Now, if you don't mind.
We're getting close. That was a journey to Bernie, but we're playing Journey to Ernie. Come on. Ernie! Wait a minute. Do you see what I see? That shadow looks like Ernie's hair. And if that's his shadow, Ernie must be here. Oh, no. It's not Ernie. It's a sleeping iguana. How are we ever gonna find Ernie?
Don't give up.
Oh, thanks, iguana. Wait a minute. That sounded like... Behind the iguana, that's got to be...
You found me!
We found him! We found Ernie! Yay!
It's Ernie.
It's me.
I'd know you anywhere. But when you laugh, that Ernie shirt and hair, the squeaking of your ducky tells us you're the one.
Ooh.
We found him, we found him. La, 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 la. Our journey to Ernie is done.
I love this game.
Wait till you see where I hide next time.
Ooh.
Right.
You know, there sure are a lot of letters on a computer keyboard, Skyla.
Yep.
Oh, hi there. I'm Ernie, and this is my friend Skyla. And, of course, that's my friend Rubber Ducky. And Skyla and I are playing today with the computer, and we're going to play a game, right?
Right.
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Let me explain this game to you. See, here's what's going to happen. You are going to cover your eyes. Close your eyes. You don't have to do it yet. I'm just telling you about it. And that way you won't be able to see that I'm going to type a word on the computer, and then you get to guess what word it is. Think you can do that?
Yeah.
I think you can, too. Okay, cover your eyes. Okay, you sure you can't see? You're not peeking, are you? Okay, here goes. Here goes the word. I'm going to type this word. Here goes. Boom. Boom. There's a word on the computer. Okay, Skyla, do you know what word I typed?
No.
That's right! Uncover your eyes! She got it right! She got the word no, N-O. Oh, you're such a good guesser. I can't believe you got that.
Steady, Sydney. Oh, hello there. It is I, your furry blue world traveler, Grover. Do not lose my lunch, Sydney. Here to say, I just got back from Egypt, and boy, is my camel tired. Ah, ha, 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 ha. Wow! He comes from Egypt, so walking across the desert was easy for him. Swimming across the ocean, that's another story. Even though he is called a ship of the desert, he only does the camel paddle. Oh, and another thing, he also carried back my yummy Egyptian lunch in this basket. Mm-hmm. I will eat it right after I tell you how I got it. I went to Egypt to see my friend Ahmed. He lives in this big city called Cairo. We left Cairo to visit his cousins who grow vegetables on a farm. That's Ahmed. His father took us on the minibus. Outside Cairo, everything was greener, except for a donkey. He was browner. At the farm, his cousins, Mohammed and Zainab, were happy to see him. Right away, they did things you cannot do in a major city, like play tag in a bean field. Then they planted a lot of seeds in the ground that could grow into a million fava beans.
try this in a parking lot. In Egypt, all fruit and vegetables are grown in the country. Then they washed the dirt off and kneaded dough for aish. That's what they call bread. And Zeynep and her mommy, Karima, baked the aish, and it was finger-licking good. And when we helped milk a goat, we all got a drink of goat's milk. Creamy. Mmm, delicious. Then guess what? More food. We took bread with our fingers and dipped it into the food and ate it. And no dishes to wash. Pretty smart, huh? Whatever we did, there was always food. Nice place. And when it was time to stop eating and leave, guess what they gave us as a goodbye present? Food. A basket of goodies for me to eat on Sesame Street. My lunch! The ducks got off at Canada. And that is how I got my lunch from Egypt. Time to eat! Oh, I am so hungry. Famished even. Ready to devour a big piece of tasty aish. And a swig of creamy goat's milk, too. My lunch! Sydney! What? I cannot believe he ate the whole thing! What a global shock. What? Sydney, now you have had your lunch. We are going all the way back to Egypt to get a lunch from me.
Not now. I'm on my lunch break.
What? Well, very well, Sydney. There are other ways to travel. Taxi! Taxi! Taxi!
Well, here it is, my favorite time of the day. The time we find out what is the number of the day. Yes. Am I ready? I think so. Well, who am I kidding? I've been ready all day. I've been counting the minutes till we could do this. Okay. Well, let's see. Will it be?
One.
I guess it isn't one.
Two.
Nope, not two.
Three.
Oh, this is so exciting.
Four.
Five.
Six.
Oh, I can hardly stand the suspense.
Seven.
Eight.
Oh, what will it be? Oh, what will it be?
Nine.
Ten.
It's not ten. Let's keep going.
11.
Yes, 11.
Yes, more balloons, more confetti. Oh, boy. Is this fun or what?
11. Please type the number 11.
11?
Where is another 11?
11?
Try again.
11.
You win 11 elephants.
11.
Oh, I love that.
Let's see what the judge says.
11! And that's the number of the day.
Meatball!
Hey, we playing with balls!
Meatball!
Happy now! You being bully!
Me bully?
You bully?
Me no bully!
Yes, you bully!
What is bully?
Help me explain bully.
Interpretive dance?
No!
Uh-oh! How about song?
Yeah!
Yeah!
Uno, dos, tres, cuatro!
Pino wasn't nice, he took ball. Acted like a bully, being mean to all. Bully, bully.
Bully, bully.
Don't be a bully.
Don't be a bully. Bully, bully. Bully, bully. Don't be a bully.
Don't get monsters wrong, want to be Pino's friend. But if Pino act like bully, friendship has to end. Bully, bully.
Bully, bully.
Don't be a bully.
Don't be a bully.
Bully, bully. Bully, bully. Don't be a bully.
Pino tell monsters that the thing me do is me gonna be nice and me share with you. Bully, bully.
Bully, bully.
Me not a bully.
Don't be a bully.
Bully, bully.
Here, ball back. May me play?
Yeah!
Let's play!
Yeah! Oh,
it's fun to be woolly woolly and not bully bully.
Oh, you got to
dinosaur.
dangerous, too. Oh, huh? Okay, yeah. And she wants to know, how do you pretend to be a dinosaur? Oh, good question, Dorothy. Let's ask Mr. Noodle. Mr. Noodle! Thank you, Shay. Oh, hi, Mr. Noodle. Hello. Dorothy asks, how do you pretend to be a dinosaur? Well, take off the earmuffs, Mr. Noodle. No, the earmuffs. Take them off. Take off the earmuffs. Dorothy says... sorry, Mr. Noodle, sorry. How do you pretend you're a dinosaur, Mr. Noodle? A dinosaur.
No, that's ballet.
That's not a dinosaur.
That's a dancer.
A dinosaur is an animal, Mr. Noodle, from long ago.
Yeah, millions of years ago.
Mr. Noodle.
Not a monkey.
We said a dinosaur.
That's not a dinosaur.
Not at all.
Dinosaurs were big and tall.
Some were.
Yeah, they could stand on their hind legs, Mr. Noodle.
Some could.
Bigger. They were bigger than buildings.
A walking building.
Yay!
That's it. Good job.
Great. He did it.
He's roaring.
No, Mr.
He's scared himself.
Don't be scared, Mr. Noodle. That's just your reflection.
Mr. Noodle. Yay! Yeah.
That's you in the mirror, not a real dinosaur.
Right, it's you.
But you sure are a great dinosaur, Mr. Noodle.
Bye, Mr. Noodle.
What's that, Dorothy? What's that? Oh, Dorothy wants to ask someone else. How do you pretend to be a dinosaur?
Dorothy, this is how I pretend to be a brontosaurus. I have a long neck and eat leaves off of trees. Yum, 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 yum.
Dorothy, this is how I pretend to be a pterosaur. I have wings and I fly like a bird.
Dorothy, I'm a Tyrannosaurus Rex. I have sharp teeth, I run fast, and I eat other dinosaurs.
Wow! Dorothy says you remind her of her Uncle Jaws. Thanks, everybody. Oh, and thanks, Dorothy. Now, I'm going to ask a baby. Oh, hello, baby. Baby, how do you pretend to be a dinosaur? Oh, boy. Thank you, baby. Kiss, kiss, kiss. Boy, that was a cute baby. Oh, and now, Elmo has a question for you. Yeah, you. How many baby dinosaurs will hatch from these eggs? Let's count them and see.
One.
One baby stegosaurus.
Two. Three. Four.
Tyrannosaurus Rex. Oh, where you going? Bye, dinosaur. Baby T-Rex. Bye. Oh, great counting, everybody. Stegosaurus is one kind of dinosaur. Elmo wonders what other kind of dinosaurs there are. Oh, draw. Look at that. Try to kiss him. Is this a dinosaur?
Yes.
That's a brontosaurus.
What a neck.
It can wear lots of neckties. Is this a dinosaur?
No, it's a birthday cake.
But you could put dinosaurs on your cake. Are these dinosaurs?
Yes.
And yes. They all are. Is this a dinosaur?
Snuffleupagus.
Not today. Today, I'm a Snuffleosaurus. Roar!
Or a Dino-upagus. Thank you, Drew.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
A Computerosaurus.
Elmo has mail. Elmo has mail.
Elmo would like his email.
Elmo has mail.
Oh, Elmo's got email from his friend Ernie.
If you're thinking about dinosaurs, Elmo, old buddy, don't forget my favorite.
And here it comes now. It's Rubber Duckyosaurus. You're so cute.
Thank you, computer. Elmo's friend Kate loves dinosaurs. So her mommy took her to the museum so she could see huge dinosaur bones. And she told Elmo all about it.
Dinosaurs aren't alive anymore, so you have to go to a museum to see them, like the American Museum of Natural History. Scientists called paleontologists dig up the fossils of dinosaur bones, and they put together skeletons which show how big they were. One of the first skeletons we saw was awesome. It's called a Barosaurus. When I looked up at it, I felt tiny. It has the longest neck of any dinosaur found in North America. We found Triceratops with three big horns and a big collar. We also saw dinosaur eggs. How could something as big as a dinosaur grow from something that small? Tyrannosaurus rex. It has tiny arms and big legs and sharp teeth. They're sharp because it eats meat. We found Stegosaurus. I think it's the cutest. I like the plates on its back. The last one we saw, the Apatosaurus, was humongous, and it was put together from 350 dinosaur bones. There's a make-believe skeleton we put together, just like paleontologists do. Maybe I'll be a paleontologist someday.
Paleontologist. Where can Elmo learn more about a paleontologist? A TV-osaur. Elmo can learn more on the Dinosaur Channel. Come on, TV. Okay, turn yourself on.
It's the Dinosaur Channel. All dinos, all newts, all the time. Dino devotees, here's paleontologist Bones Martin digging up dirt about dinosaurs.
Hi, I'm Bones Martin, and I'm a paleontologist. I dig dinosaurs. And I make dino skeletons. Shazam! And here's the secret about dinosaurs. Dinosaurs moved. They were alive. They didn't just stand in some museum waiting for closing time. These legs were meant for walking and running and, yes, dancing. Hit it! Swing your tail from side to side. Swing it, show some dino pride. Stamp those feet upon the ground. Make the earth shake all around you. Give your tail another whomp. Stamp your feet and start to romp. Paleontology in motion. When the dinosaur stomped. Let's get real. It's Lambiosaurus and the Dinettes. Okay, dance with the dinosaurs. Swing your tail from side to side. Swing it, show some dino pride. Stamp those feet upon the ground. Make the earth shake all around you. Give your tail another whomp. Stamp your feet and start to romp. Ornithomimus, folks, tops in taps. Doing a dinosaur storm. dinosaurs. Watch it, Jumbo.
Stay tuned for Dinosaur, Bob Fossil, and Dudley Diggs. And the bigger they are, the harder they fall.
Thanks, Stevie. Oh, Elmo wants to learn even more about dinosaurs, don't you? How can we find out even more?
No. Why don't you ask a dinosaur?
It's a dinosaur, yay!
Yes, it is. I'm a dinosaur, and I was born 150 million years ago, wow. Give or take. But I saw everything. Oh, ask me a question.
Well, what did Mr. Dinosaur see?
Well, I saw asteroids, and I saw the sun rise every day like clockwork, and I saw the stars, and the comets, and the rocks.
Well, what else?
Well, I saw rivers to swim in, and trees with tasty leaves just like these. Oh, most of all, I saw dinosaurs everywhere. Big ones, little ones, calm ones, excited ones. Dinosaurs were the people in my neighborhood, son.
Wow! Well, did you have a bird in your neighborhood? Like Big Bird?
Well, we had a pterosaur flying in the sky. Kind of like a dinosaur with wings. What a guy. Always up with that big smile. Yeah.
A pterosaur. Oh, look. Dorothy's imagining Elmo as a pterosaur. Flying over Mr. Dinosaur's neighborhood 150 million years ago.
You look good in teeth, son.
Pterosaur. Hello, Elmo's a pterosaur. Whee!
There weren't just dinosaurs. There were all kinds of animals. Frogs, turtles, mice.
Hello, frog. Hello, turtle. Hello, mouse.
And crocodiles. Yow! They're always good for a laugh. Ah! Most dinosaurs ate leaves 24/7. Others ate meat, including dinosaurs.
What's that, T-Rex? Yeah, baby!
And that's the way it was.
Thank you, Mr. Dinosaur.
No problem, kid.
Oh, don't go away, Mr. Dinosaur.
What?
Dorothy wants to sing that dinosaur song.
Ooh!
Yeah. This one's a golden oldie.
Oh, just like me. 150 million years old, and I still don't feel a day over 145 million.
Oh, ha. Cool. Here we go. Do-do-do-do-do. Dinosaur, dinosaur, dinosaur. Come on, everybody.
Dinosaur, dinosaur, dinosaur. Dinosaur, dinosaur.
Bye-bye, have a nice age!
That's right, Slimy. It's time for another chapter of The Adventures of Trash Gordon. Oh, he just loves reading trash. Here we go. Chapter 692.
When we last left our hero, he was on the planet Snore a lot, trying to get some sleep. Even heroes need some shut-eye. Unfortunately, all the Snoretians were snoring. Even the pillows and blankets were snoring. It was a sight for snore eyes. How would Trash ever get to sleep with all that noise? Luckily, our hero had brought along something noisier, his bugle. Everyone woke up. Trash heroically turned to them and said,
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letter Z and by the number 11.
Then our hero boldly fell asleep. No, no,
no, no. That's enough thrills for now, Slimo. Just hit the sack and I'll read you more trash tomorrow. Ah, he loves adventures.
To learn more about Sesame Street, visit us at pbskids.org.
Thank you.